Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to this very special Transformers The Last Night fan event! Well, you are sitting in currently right now one of the locations Michael Bay chose for the movie, and it plays a role in, let's just say, a rather pivotal scene, and that's all I'm going to say about that. Now, tonight we are bringing the stars of Transformers Last Night to a global audience. Not only do we have you guys sitting here in London, but we are being joined by thousands of fans watching online. So a big hello to you and welcome to this Transformers live Q&A. So with that in mind, all that's left to do is welcome the incredible cast and director who have brought this movie to the big screen. Make some noise, first of all, for Gerard Carmichael, Isabella Mona, Josh Duhamel, Laura Haddock, Mark Wahlberg, and of course, the director of the film, Mr. Michael Bay! Guys, wonderful to have you here. Thank you very much for being here. Let's kick straight off, Michael, with you. Tell us, The Last Night, where did the idea for the story behind The Last Night come from?
We had 12 writers to come up with the mythology where different spin-offs could happen. So we created a whole Bible, and Steven Spielberg and I liked two of the ideas. We combined them together, and here we are. So I'm not going to tell you much, but it is a big adventure story, and hope you guys like it.
Mark, let me turn to you now. You shot not only in this very church, but at some incredible locations around the UK. First of all, what is it like to shoot here? And B, what is it like to be back, man?
Well, it's nice. For me, being in a church is always a special place. Although I did get reminded from Laura not to swear in a church. Usually I only spend about an hour at a time in a church. Now, we were spent well over 12 hours in this gorgeous building, so I slipped a few times, but I'm able to get to confession, you know, and be forgiven. But it's certainly nice to be back. But this is the first time I really shot for any real length of time in the UK, and this is by far the most impressive location. I'm still trying to figure out the history and the origin behind Stonehenge. I get it. I don't get it at all. So, and Michael built another Stonehenge right down the road that was equally as impressive, and we were able to blow it up.
Let's turn to some of the questions that have been coming in already online for you guys. This is one for everyone, and this is from @BeyondEnder from Slovenia. Thank you for your question. If you were a Transformer, would you be an Autobot or a Decepticon, and why? Gerard, I'm going to start with you down that end. Autobot and Decepticon. You're just admiring the church.
Yeah, I mean, this church, I think this church is older than religion. Like, I think it's like, it used to, and is this an actual, is there a dead person in here? Are we just like plugging a film in front of a dead
they're
saint?
Their knight's buried.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I think that I would be an Autobot, but I have the soul of a Decepticon. At least that's what it says in my Tinder profile. I don't know.
Josh, over to you. Autobot, Decepticon, and indeed why?
Autobot or Decepticon, the Decepticons are obviously a lot more fun, a lot more destructive.
They
but,
die
you
quicker.
Know, I don't know. I have a... It's such a difficult question because, you know, I don't want to be defined by either. I mean, obviously I'm going to say that I want to be an Autobot, but I probably behave like a Decepticon on Tinder. I don't have a Tinder account. I'm just
girls
kidding.
Like Decepticons, man. I'm telling
no, but the truth is I have a 69 Camaro, yellow with the black pinstripes. That my son thinks is Bumblebee. He actually thinks is Bumblebee. He's waiting for it to transform. So for that, I guess I have an affinity for the Autobots.
Mark, how about yourself?
Me? Whatever Michael Bay tells me.
Michael, this is coming for you from Paul Burney, who's in Dublin. Paul, thank you for your question. Michael Bay, and this is a big one, is this really your last Transformers movie?
Yeah, it is. It is. No, I just wanted to set this one up and leave it to, I don't know, someone else to take this beast on, you know? It's been a good run. You are way too young, all right?
Vimal from Poland says, don't stop making Transformers. So that's a command right there.
I want to know what happens if we stop making Transformers. I want to know what happens to that guy.
It was a
threat. What did he do? Is he holding his family hostage in a basement? Did you ask that? Did you ask what happens if we stop making Transformers? Because that sounds like a threat.
Vimal, if you want to get back in touch and just tell us your family is safe, that'd be lovely. As I was saying, Smoke Trail Prime says, Mark, did you need to be trained with a sword before actually using one in The Last Knight? Because there's that badass scene where you've got a sword.
I told Michael, I said, dude, I carry swords all the time. I said, relax. And then they put that thing in my hand. It's about 50 pounds. I'm like, oh my God, we're going to swing this thing? So we kind of did on-the-job training.
Laura, this is coming from Alicia JPS from Newcastle, who says, what was it like shooting in the different places in England?
Awesome. Michael took us on he was like our tour guide, and he took us on a tour of the UK, and just anywhere that was on the list of places to go, we seemed to go and, I was about to say blow up, but we didn't. It was amazing. Yeah.
Churchill's house, Blenheim Palace. Well, we did an explosion there, and
we won't be allowed.
I've got it on my video. There's a top little teeny window that survived World War II. I blew it out. Original glass. I blew it out. I've got it right here on my video. It's pretty sad.
I think that's called evidence. next question, and this is for you, Michael, from Alfonso Nation, who is from the USA, who says, filming with IMAX cameras is new to the world of cinema. What were the main challenges of building the 3D cameras you used in The Last Knight?
Well, it's the first movie that we really use real IMAX size sensors. First 3D IMAX movie where it's... were two real cameras, not like the little cheapo thing I did on the last one. So the 3D is way better on this. It's a big beast too. I was gonna say the word ass, I'm sorry. It's a big beast to move around. It weighs about 160 pounds. We had three units. You know, you really should see this in IMAX. The 3D is great.
And you guys, are you gonna be seeing it later? So, yeah.
Yeah. Are you paying? Is it for free? That's a lot of money. Movie was expensive, okay?
There'll be a donation
box at the end, okay?
Gerard, this is coming from Gabriel Canavy in Sheffield, who says, Gerard, who is your favorite Transformer and why?
And the other thing, did we ever find out about the dude's family or no? We're just gonna let that ride? All right. My favorite Transformer, not to sound cliche, I mean, Optimus Prime, it's really exciting, you know, watching how he evolves during the film, and you get chills watching him, you know, at the end is very exciting. So I would say Optimus.
Mark, this is coming for you from Alice, who's on Facebook and is from Brazil. Did you get to drive any of the cars while filming Transformers?
Yes, but you got to understand, like, Michael is like a bodyguard for all the expensive cars. Yeah. You can't even get close to it. You can't touch it.
They're in hair and makeup for longer than I am.
Yeah. So if you're like...
That's a long time.
But I spent a lot of time driving B, and he'd never let me in the Bugattis or the Lambos.
He's a good driver, though. We call him Wheel Man.
What happens to the cars after you use...
My house.
Yeah, there's They're one in my house. Hallway.
I got two bumblebees and I got Barricade.
Yeah. It's just that I'm getting my license soon, so, I mean...
Yeah, no. That's not happening.
This is from Luca, who's in Mexico, and he asks on Facebook, and this is for Isabella and Laura. What was your favorite part of playing such strong female characters? I'll start with you, Isabella.
I mean, I gotta say, when it comes to a strong female character, I think that I like that any strong male character would do the same. You know, just go straight into battle.
Agree, gender neutral. What
I was doing, Mark was doing, and what Mark was doing, I was doing. I was sometimes doing it backwards and in heels. So, right?
So, this is for you, Michael. We have to finish the Q&A talking about the newest star in the movie, which is, of course, Freya. Tell us a little bit about Freya and who Freya is.
Freya is a dog. I'm a huge dog lover, and I saw a news article that was over here when I was in the States, reading at night, and I'm like, it was the loneliest dog in all of England. And they had 18,000 people come visit this dog. The dog, it was a pit bull, 6 years old, had epilepsy. She's cute, but no one wanted her. So I decided to call the kennel where the dog was going to stay, and I said, let's just give this dog a part in Transformers. And it made every talk show here. It made it to the States even. And dog was adopted. By this nice gentleman, and the deal was he adopted the dog, and the dog acted in the movie with Anthony Hopkins. And Anthony Hopkins, I mean, the dog was fantastic, all right? And Tony, we call him Tony. Tony loved the dog, and so working with an Oscar-winning actor. It's a good story, huh? Huh?
Unfortunately, that is all we have time for. Let's hear it for Gerard Carmichael, Isabella Mona, Josh Duhamel, Laura Haddock, Mark Wahlberg, and of course, Mr. Michael Bay. You'll want to see the movie when it hits cinemas. Check us out. We're live from the global premiere on Sunday. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you.